الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم brothers and sisters. Welcome to all of you to our fifth lesson on Understand Quran and Salah the Easy Way. In this one, after studying Surah Al-Fatiha in our previous lesson, our previous lessons, we will focus on the purpose of revelation and take some ayat and hadith. Then we will go to the end of the Quran and pick up last surahs. So let us take, and also we will study grammar and learn some educational tips. By the end of this lesson, we will learn inshallah 32 words which occur in the Quran almost 16,892 times. Very precious. So let us start with this verse, surahs of Surah Sad. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. كتاب, كتاب, it's a book. كتاب and كتب have come in the Quran almost 263 times, very many times. كتاب is singular, كتب is plural. كتاب means a book. أنزلنا, we sent down. أنزلنا, we sent down. Okay, أنزلنا who? We sent down it. Or we sent it down. The proper translation is we sent it down, or we have revealed it also is okay, but the best translation is we sent it down. Ilaika, to you. Ila means to, ka means you. You join the two. Ilaika, to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mubarakun, full of blessings. We say Eid Mubarak. Eid Mubarak meaning what? Let this Eid be a blessing for you. So this book is a book of blessings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we have revealed this book which is full of blessings. Please note that Allah did not say that I have revealed this book for blessings. Yes, it is book of blessing, but he is giving the purpose of revelation after this. That is, to receive these full blessings we have to do two things, which is tadabbur and tadakkur, which we will come to that. So let us practice. Kitabun means it's a book. Anzalnahu, we have revealed it. Ilaika, to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mubarakun, full of blessings. Again, kitabun,
it's a book.
Anzalnahu,
we have revealed it.
Ilaika,
to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Mubarakun,
full of blessings.
Why has he revealed it? Yes, it is a book of barakah. And what we did, we know, we just made it a book of barakah, meaning what? We keep in the house so that our salaries are, you know, we don't need extra money, some money will be saved, or we don't, you know, come across with any accidents and things like that. We have a small sense of barakah in our life in general. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give comprehensive barakah. And he says, why have I revealed it? It's coming there. First thing is, liyadabbaru ayatihi. So that they ponder its verses. Li means so that. Okay? Li means so that. Liyadabbaru, so that they ponder. Liyadabbaru, so that they ponder. Ayatihi. Ayah has two meanings. Okay? Sign and verse. Sign and verse. Two meanings. The plural of ayah is ayat. Plural of ayah is ayat. Ayatihi, its verses. You see, we may have studied, we have studied Rabbuhu, Rabbuhum, or Fihi, Fihim, Rabbihi, Rabbihim. In Arabic, either it is masculine or feminine. There is no neutral gender, a neutral gender like its. So ayatihi means his verses, but here it means book's verses, its verses. Book is masculine in Arabic. Ayatihi, its verses. Liyadabbaru ayatihi, so that they ponder its verses. That is first purpose. What is tadabbur? By the way, let me just talk about tadabbur. So that they ponder. What is pondering? You take a newspaper. You just read the newspaper and you know what the story is about. You don't have to go back again and again to understand what is written there in general. But can you read a book of mathematics, science, physics, commerce, finance, the same way as you read a newspaper? No. At every step you have to stop. How come this step is coming from those before that? You start thinking over, pondering. Otherwise you cannot continue. You cannot read a book of mathematics like a newspaper, a book of finance, a book of commerce, a book of science. So that is tadabbur, and that is the purpose of revelation. You may have studied so many books. In no book you may have seen that, you know, written like, please think over this book, please ponder this book, or understand this book. Because books are written for understanding and thinking over. But our situation is strange. I am talking of the traditional Muslims. In spite of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning in the Quran that I have revealed this for pondering, this is the only book that we don't understand and don't ponder its verses. This is really big tragedy. And we don't teach our students how to ponder. What are we doing? What kind of Muslims are we? If we don't teach our students how to ponder the verses, who's going to teach? And if we don't understand the Quran, how can we ponder its verses? The verses are only in Arabic. Remember, the Arabic Quran is the Quran. The second purpose is وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Li is so that, وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ, and so that they receive admonition. So that they receive admonition. Who? Ulul Albab. Ulu and Uli is those of. Ulul Albab, Lub is singular, Albab is plural. People of intellect. So the purpose of revelation is to do tadabbur and tadakkur. To think over and to receive admonition. To take lessons, that is to implement. Understand, think over and implement. That is the purpose of revelation. And if we do that, then we get the full barakah, inshallah. How to bring Quran into our lives? That is how to do tadabbur and tadakkur. Tadakkur to bring it into our life. Tadakkur is to bring the Quran into our life. We have a simple formula, but before we go there, before we start talking about pondering and bringing it into our life, let us look at our relationship with the Quran. Our relationship with the Quran is direct, personal, planned, and relevant. Direct. When we read the Quran, we say this is the book of Allah. So whenever we hear it, don't say that this imam is reciting. It is Allah talking to us. Quran is a live book. It's not a dead book. It's a live book. When, you know, if you take any other book, if the author is sitting behind this wall, he may not even know that you are reading his book. But as soon as you open the Quran, Allah starts talking to you and he wants to see your reaction. How you are reacting. It is personal. That is, take everything for me. You know, don't say these verses are for disbelievers, those who are idolaters, these are hypocrites, these are for Yahud and Nasara. Then what is there for me? In fact, I should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I mean, I should take it as if it is addressing me. Plant. You see, we say everything is part of Qadr. Even if a grain that we eat is part of the Qadr. Therefore, every ayah that we hear or listen to or read is part of the fate which was written there before even we were born. So everything is planned. So I should ask, O Allah, why did you make me hear this verse today? If Allah says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and be nice to parents, then I ask, O Allah, why did you tell me today? I should check my relationship with my parents. Relevant. Quran is a reminder. How can Allah's reminder be relevant? In fact, again, I should think and say, O Allah, why did you ask me today? Why me? Why did you tell me about this? And why today? So remember the relationship, direct, plan, personal, relevant. Direct, personal, plan, relevant, whatever. Direct, personal, plan, and relevant. So take every verse as if it is directed at us at that moment, for that day, for that event. This is first thing. Next thing is to, once you understand the relationship, to start doing tadabbur, you have to fulfill certain conditions. For example, first of all, you should focus, understand, imagine, and feel. These are some of the conditions. focus. That is, you should have complete focus on the Quran. Focus of your eyes, if you are praying, don't look here and there. Ears, don't listen to anything else. Body, don't play around. Brain, don't think anything else. Heart, don't be attached to anything else. Just attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Focus. Understand. Without understanding, how can we ponder? So try to catch, even if you are learning, try to catch every word. Don't say, I don't know under Quran. Just try to catch. If Musa alayhi salam, oh, it is the story of Musa alayhi salam. Or Jannah, Jahannam, whatever, try to catch as much as you can. Okay? So you will start developing more and more understanding. Imagine, whenever signs are mentioned, history is mentioned, or hell is mentioned, try to explode your imagination, try to live there and feel. And if it is heaven, enjoy it. I mean, and feel it. And if it is hell, feel the punishments. And try to, you know, try to imagine the details and feel. Feeling is what? Don't recite the Quran like a newsreader. Like Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin. You know, recite it from your heart. Say it from your heart. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin. Say it from your heart. And have hope when you read verses of mercy of Allah. And have fear when you read verses of punishment, and so on. So focus, here is the logo, you can focus on that, I mean you can look at that. In the center we have focus, understand, imagine and feel. On the top, our relationship, direct, personal, plan and relevant. And to bring Quran into our life, we have four steps: ask, evaluate, plan and propagate. Why ask? Because each verse of the Quran demands something from us. To fulfill it, start with supplication. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, for example, help me do tadabbur and tadakkur for the verse that we recited. Evaluate. You know, just asking is not enough. Like a student who is going to Fajr, Zuhar, Asr, and praying to Allah for success in exams, but never goes to school, never opens a book. No, you evaluate. What did I do yesterday? Did I open the Quran? Last week. Make a plan. Evaluation is for the past. If you have done, Alhamdulillah. If not, Astaghfirullah. But what do you want to do now? Plan. Today, next week, where is your plan? If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. If you don't have plan to eat tonight for dinner, then you plan to stay hungry. If you don't have plan to study Quran, you have plan not to study the Quran. Okay? And then propagate. بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. The Prophet ﷺ said, convey from me even if it is one verse. So ask, evaluate, plan and propagate. And that's our logo. Ask, evaluate, plan and propagate. Just follow that. And inshallah, you will get a lot of ideas from this and a good way to interact. This is just one way to interact with the Quran. As far as planning is concerned, just be, you know, take a note there. When it comes to group of fiqh issues or any new idea, then please check with the scholars before you mention it to others or implement it yourself. Then what is the common area for us? What's the area that we should be acting upon? There are many areas in the Quran which can be acted upon immediately, like relationship with Allah, following the Prophet ﷺ, planning for the hereafter, dhikr, worship, morals, dealings, da'wah, preaching, propagation, so many, team spirit, so many things are there that we can work on. Brothers and sisters, we'll take a break inshallah here. We'll continue with grammar. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Welcome to you again in the second part of the lesson, the fifth lesson, in which we will learn some more grammar. Please note that we will be using total physical interaction, that is, you are listening to us, you are watching us. Try to repeat what we say and also show what we say the way we say it or the way we show it. It will really be very helpful in learning different forms of words that are derived from one word or one root in Arabic grammar. We started with huwa, hum, anta, antum, ana, nahnu. Okay, and I'm sure by now you have learned the meanings of these six words. Can you repeat after me? Huwa, hum.
Huwa, hum.
Anta, antum.
Anta, antum.
Ana, nahnu.
Ana, nahnu.
And also you have learned these hu, hum, ka, kum, I, na. By the way, you know, what's the meaning of huwa?
He.
Hum?
they,
أنت,
you,
أنتم,
you all,
أنا,
I,
نحن,
we.
هم كاكم إنا is his, their, your, my, and our. And we have used it in attached forms like Rabbuhu is his Rabb. Can you translate Rabbuhu?
His Rabb.
Rabbuhum?
Their Rabb.
Rabbuka?
Your Rabb.
Rabbukum?
Your Rabb.
Rabbi?
My Rabb.
Rabbuna?
Our Rabb.
And also we have learned Huwa is he. Okay? And Hiya is
she.
Rabbuhu is his Rabb. Rabbuha?
Her Rabb.
Okay? And also we told you that there are three types of words in Arabic language. Ism is noun, that is for names and attributes. Second is verb, fa'il, which tells us about an action. And the third type is letter, which joins nouns and or verbs. These are different types of letters, li, min, ala, an, inna, and so on. We'll take four of them, la and li, min, an, and ma. The first three are preposition, fourth is not, but whatever. Just note down the meanings. La and li is for. Min is from, an is with, ma is with. There are other meanings also, but we will stick to basic meanings in the beginning. These four letters, along with hu, hum, ka, kum, ina, come in the Quran almost 5,000 times. So we will be doing that exercise in this session. Take a deep breath, stand upright or sit upright, pray to Allah Rabbi Zidni Ilma, and let us do it with TPI. So the first one, which is Lam, with Zabar or Fatha or Zair or Kasra, La or Li, both mean for. It also means two and others, but right now we will just use one meaning, which is for. And there is a verse in the Quran, Lakum Deenukum Waliya Deeni. Lakum, for you, your religion, and for me, mine. Sometimes it is translated as to you, your religion, and to me, mine. But whatever. The point is, we are here to explain the one meaning of La, which is for. La and Li both mean for. And just remember the example, Lakum Deenukum Waliya Deeni. So if la and li means for, what is the meaning of lahu for him? Okay, just join the two. Lahu is
for him.
So please translate lahu for him. Or repeat after me. Lahu for him.
Lahu for him.
Lahum for them.
Lahu for them.
Laka for you.
Laka for you.
Lakum for you all.
Lakum for you all.
Li for me.
Li for me.
Lana for us.
Lana for us.
Laha for her.
Laha for her.
Lahu for him.
Lahu for him.
Lahum for them.
Lahu for them.
Laka for you.
Laka for you.
Lakum for you all.
Lakum for you all.
Li for me.
Li for me.
Lana for us.
Lana for us.
Laha for her.
Laha for her.
Can you translate? Lahu
for him.
Lahum
for them.
Laka
for you.
Lakum
for you all.
Li
for me.
Lana
for us.
Laha
for her.
Now think in Arabic and repeat after me. Lahu lahum.
Lahu lahum.
Laka lakum.
Laka lakum.
Li lana.
Li lana.
Lahu lahum.
Lahu lahum.
Laka lakum.
Laka lakum.
Li lana.
Li lana.
Laha.
Laha.
Last time. Lahu lahum.
Lahu lahum.
Laka lakum.
Laka lakum.
Li lana.
Li lana.
Laha.
Laha.
The second one is min, okay? Min means from, and the best example is أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أعوذ, I take refuge, بالله in Allah. Min is from Satan. So if you forget the meaning, just remember the example. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. So min means from. Therefore, min who means from him, okay? Repeat after me, okay? Min who from him?
Min who from him?
Min hum from them?
Min hum from them?
Minka from you?
Minka from you?
Minkum from you all?
Minkum from you all?
Minni from me?
Minni from me?
Minna from us?
Minna from us?
Minha from her?
Minha from her?
Min who from him?
Min who from him?
Min hum from them?
Min hum from them?
Minka from you?
Minka from you?
Minkum from you all?
Minkum from you all? Minni from me.
Minha from us.
Minha from her.
These seven words come in the Quran 3,026 times. You know, very, very, very precious. So can you translate? Minhu? Yeah, all of you, please. Minhu?
From him.
Minhum?
From them.
Minka?
From you.
Minkum?
From you all.
Minni?
From me.
Minna?
From us.
Minha?
From her.
Again. Minhu?
From him.
Minhum?
From them.
Minka?
From you.
Minkum?
From you all.
Minni?
From me.
Minna?
From us.
Minha?
From her.
MashaAllah. Now repeat after me in Arabic, thinking what you're saying. Minhu, minhum.
Minhu, minhum.
Minka, minkum.
Minka, minkum.
Minni, minna.
Minni, minna.
Minha.
Minha.
Minhu, minhum.
Minhu, minhum.
Minka, minkum.
Minka, minkum.
Minni, minna.
Minni, minna.
Minha.
Minha.
Last time. Minhu, minhum.
Minhu, minhum.
Minka, minkum.
Minka, minkum.
Minni, minna.
Minni, minna.
Minha.
Minha.
With me. Can you say with me? I mean, repeat with me. Minhu, minhum, minka, minkum, minni, minna, minhu, sorry, minhu, minhum, minka, minkum, minni, minna, minha. Once more. Minhu, minhum, minka, minkum, minni, minna, minha. I'm repeating this, you know, making you repeat this so that you get familiar with these words. So next time they come in the Quran, they don't remain strange words. You are familiar with them. So developing familiarity with these words is the first step. That's why I'm asking you to translate each and every word and also asking you to practice the meanings and the forms. Let's take the third preposition, which is an. An means with. One of the meanings. And the best example is radiyallahu anhu. May Allah be pleased with him. Okay, may Allah be pleased with him. We use this for sahaba radiyallahu anhum. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So an means with, therefore anhu means with him. Okay, so repeat after me. Anhu with him.
Anhu with him.
Anhum with them.
Anhum with them.
Anka with you.
Anka with you.
Ankum with you all.
Ankum with you all.
Anni with me.
Anni with me.
Anna with us.
Anna with us.
Anha with her.
Anha with her.
Translate anhu with him. Anhum?
With them.
Anka?
With you.
Ankum?
With you all.
Anni?
With me.
Anna?
With us.
Anha?
With her.
With me in Arab, after me in Arabic. Anhu, anhum?
Anhu, anhum.
May Allah be pleased with him, with them, with you all, with me. All of us need the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with this prayer. Anhu, anhum?
Anhu, anhum.
Anka, ankum?
Anka, ankum.
Anni, anna?
Anni, anna.
Anha?
Anha.
Anhu anhum.
Anhu anhum.
Anka ankum.
Anka ankum.
Anni anna.
Anni anna.
Anha.
Anha.
Can you repeat with me? Anhu anhum. Anka ankum. Anni anna. Anha. Okay. We'll go to the last one, which is not a preposition, but it comes with different forms. Ma'a, which is with. And the best example is Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. Indeed, Allah is with those who are patient. MashaAllah, you're listening, you're watching, you're working with patience. Allah, inshallah, is with you and us, all of us. So ma'a means with. So ma'ahu means with him. So repeat after me. Ma'ahu with him.
Ma'ahu with him.
Ma'ahum with them.
Ma'ahum with them.
Ma'aka with you.
Ma'aka with you.
We say Allah ma'ak. Allah be with you. Ma'akum with you all.
Ma'akum with you all.
Ma'i with me.
Ma'i with me.
Ma'ana with us.
Ma'ana with us.
Ma'aha with her.
Ma'aha with her.
Ma'ahu with him.
Ma'ahu with him.
Can you translate? Ma'ahu.
With him.
Ma'ahum.
With them.
Ma'aka.
With you.
Ma'akum.
With you all.
Ma'i.
With me.
Ma'ana.
With us.
Ma'aha.
With her.
Repeat after me thinking what you're saying. Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'ahu, ma'ahum.
Ma'aka, ma'akum.
Ma'aka, ma'akum.
Ma'i, ma'ana.
Ma'i, ma'ana.
Ma'aha.
Ma'aha.
So all these words that we have practiced, 28 of them, come in the Quran almost 5,000 times. And always remember them with the meanings, with the examples. La and li means for. Example, lakum deenukum waliyadeen. Min is from. Example, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. An is with. Example, radiyallahu anhu. Ma'a is with. Inna Allah ma'as sabirin. If you remember the examples, you will not get confused the meanings. You can do the practice of la is for, min is from, ma an is with, ma is with. For, from, with, for, from, with. You can do this practice, you know, to learn them thoroughly. Learning tip. How will you remember me? Well, if you have, you know, if you meet me first time in a meeting or in a masjid, that will be your reference always. Suppose two of you met me, and one of you forgot. And next time you see me at the airport or some other place, and if you two are with them, if you two are together, and if one of you had forgotten, he will tell you, you know, I think we saw this person somewhere. And what will your friend tell? He will say, don't you remember that he was there in the masjid teaching the Arabic? So remembering is always there with respect to first example, first meeting. Similarly, the meanings of new words can be remembered easily when you remember the meanings of those words in examples. Let me just give an example and it will be clear. What is the meaning of word in? What is the meaning of word inshallah? If Allah wills. Most of the people, when I ask them what is the meaning of in, they will just stay blank. But when I say, do you know what's the meaning of inshallah? They will immediately say, if Allah wills. So you already know the meaning, but in the context of an example, inshallah, if Allah wills. So the best way to remember the meanings of new words is to remember them through examples. That's why la, min, an, and ma, remember them through examples and you will never forget them. This is a very strong secret of this course. All the examples that we use are familiar from the salah. So every word, every verse is familiar. So remember them thoroughly. With this we have learned, alhamdulillah, almost 32 words which occur in the Quran 16,892 times. Inshallah, we'll continue in the next lesson. We'll see you there. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.